Good morning, it's Tim Grange, and it's Wednesday in the city of Johannesburg. Beautiful weather we're having. Wherever you are, it's good to have you. I see the families coming in, Yasha, Annalisa, Umwelwa, Anita, Yvonne. Good morning, Zanelle, Noxy, Cecilia, who else, Patronella. It is good to have you all. Pastor Charlene, we need to have a chat, Pastor Charlene. Well, a lot of you, it's very important. Mbasa, good morning. David, good morning. Who else is in the house? Have you invited someone? Have you told somebody? Have you shared this link already? Have you put it on your WhatsApp status? Because there's something very interesting we're going to address today. Who else is coming in? Sorry, let me check something here quickly. Who else is coming in? Daryl, good morning. Hajira, good morning. How is Kevin? How are the kids? Joseph, good morning. Becky, good morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Who else is there? Tekofatso, good morning. I think we're good. We might as well begin. Let's pray. Coslin, good morning. Let's pray. Everlasting Father, I thank you for this time in your word. I thank you, O God, because you make our calling and our election sure. You make it sure. We stand our ground in faith. We stand our ground in truth. We stand our ground in you. Thank you, O God, because we are immovable, unshakable. We are undefeatable, for you have made us more than conquerors. Thank you, Lord, for today we stand. Receive all the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. As you can see, our topic for today, the counsel of God for today, is stand. If you missed yesterday was very crucial because the Lord spoke a prophetic word. He declared that you are a barrier breaker. Yesterday's prophetic word is extremely important. And he has taken a leaf from yesterday to emphasize a particular mindset that all barrier breakers have. And that is the ability to stand. Our core scripture is taken from Ephesians chapter 6, verse 13. I will read it from the King James, and then I'll read it from the Basic English Bible. King James says, "Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand." It didn't say, "and having done all to stand." No, it's, "and having done all," after you've done everything, he's saying, you must remain standing. The reason why I'm saying this is because sometimes, and let's be frank, we all would have experienced it. After you've done everything that you know to do, you have prophesied, you have declared, you have fasted, you have prayed a prayer of agreement, you have given, you have done everything that you know to do, it looks like nothing is happening, nothing is transpiring. Sometimes it even looks like it's getting worse. Today's word is this: no matter the circumstance, you must stand. Meaning, let me give you some of the Greek word. The Greek word for stand is itomai or something like that. But it means, amongst other things, it means to make firm, to fix, or to establish. To make firm, to fix, or to establish. You see, the Bible talks about affliction coming for the word's sake. Because sometimes in this life, even after you've done everything you know, it might seem like it's not working. It might seem like it's delaying. It might seem like it's even getting worse. What do you do under those circumstances? Paul writes it to us and tells us in Ephesians 6:13, he even starts verse 14, echoing the same sentiments. He said, stand in verse 14. He says, stand therefore. Having done all, after you've done everything you know to do, you are expected to now dig your heels into the sand and you become immovable. To stand does not mean that you are lazy, you are immobile, you are not going anywhere. No. The word stand here means to fix yourself on a position or in a position. Look at it in the Basic English Bible. It says, "For this reason, take up all the arms of God so that you may be able to be strong in the evil day." Look at this. It says, "and having done all, to keep your place." To keep your place. That opposition is coming to remove you from your place. That trial is coming to remove you from your place. That temptation has come to remove you from your place. And what is your place? Let me remind you. What is your place? Ephesians says, that you are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, far above all principalities and powers, might and dominion, and every name that can be named. You are seated in, that is your place. He has made a room, he has made space and room for you on his own throne, giving you his divine authority. That is your place. And so that challenge you are facing is trying to remove you from your place. It will not and it must not move you from your place. It is time to keep your place. Now, note this. Note this. Let me read something. It says, to stand means to make firm, to fix, and to establish. Do you understand that from God's perspective, each child of his is an establishment? You are actually an establishment. You are bigger than you think you are. From God's perspective, even though you are one person, because he's with you, you are a majority. From God's perspective, Matthew 5 tells us that you are a city. You are actually within you is a city. Within you is an establishment. What is an establishment? An establishment speaks about the powers that be. You are the power that be. It speaks about the ruling class. You are the ruling class from God's perspective. It speaks about an enterprise, and my favorite, it speaks about a conglomerate. You are in you, just you alone. You are a conglomerate from God's perspective. He refers to you as a city. Oh my goodness. He says, let your light so shine. He says that you too are the light of the world. What kind of light being must you be beaming for you to, like him, also exist as a light to the world? It means your light being is not a torchlight. Meaning again, you are an establishment. The Bible tells us, in Judges 1 verse 26, a man faced a major chaos. His city was being ransacked. His city was being sacked by an opposing force, and he just managed to escape with his family. Now, he was in a terrible state. All that he knew, all that he had in that city was completely destroyed. What did the man do in Judges 1:26? The Bible says that the man traveled away from the city that had been burnt down, went to another location, and guess what he did? He built another city. He was a city living in a city. And until the opposition came, he never realized that he had the capacity to birth an entire city. That opposition is not meant to destroy you. The enemy thinks that it will. That Goliath, the enemy thinks that it's going to destroy you, but no. That opposition, hear the voice of God, that opposition will cause you to discover that there is a city in you. And the only way you can birth that city is, in spite of that opposition, you keep your place. You keep your place. The word stand also means, let me see if I can find it here. It also means to manifest. It also means, interestingly enough, to uphold or sustain the authority or force of anything. It is time to uphold and sustain your authority. Let me show you this. You know, in your spirit, you cannot be sick. So if there's sickness in your soul, which is depression, frustration, sadness, right? If there is sickness in your body, any form of sickness in your body, it is the enemy trying to move you from your place. See, in your true state, which is your spirit, you cannot be sick. You are already established, or you're already standing in the truth of your divine health, your permanent divine health. That sickness in your soul, frustration, depression, sadness, that sickness in your body, COVID, cancer, whatever it is the enemy trying to move you from your place. It is time to stand. Do you know in your spirit, you have no debt? When Jesus died and resurrected, he said, it is finished. Basically, he was saying, paid off. In your spirit, all your debts are completely paid. You owe no man anything. That's why the Bible says, owe no man nothing but to love them. Because your spirit is established in love. And so the only thing that it can give is love. It owes no man nothing else. Now, so in your spirit, you are debt free. Now, in your natural, you might have debt. What are you supposed to do? The enemy is showing you that your your circumstance is trying to move you from your place. It is time to dig your heels into the sand and say, I am not moving. I am debt free. I'll be owed no man. I am debt free. It is possible to be debt free. I was talking to one of our people the other day, and she was explaining how her father recently passed away, and they just finished his estate, folded his estate, and he was quite wealthy. I mean, his estate came to quite a few millions. And the reason why his estate was valued that much was because he had no debt. No debt whatsoever. So it is possible. In your spirit, you are debt free. It is time to dig your heels into the ground and stand your ground, declaring, I am debt free in my spirit, so I am debt free in the natural. You need to stand your ground. Saints, listen, let me show you something. When we speak about standing, right, I want to give you an acronym. When we speak about standing, take it S-T-A-N-D. S speaks about sure. Making your election, your faith and your election sure. What do we mean? What do I mean by saying be sure? Make sure that you are sure of what you are standing on. I am talking about building, Luke 6:48, building your house on the rock. You need to make sure you have a word that you are standing on. In 2 Timothy 2:19 says, nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure. Is having this seal, the foundation of God standeth sure. You need to be assured within you that you are taking God's word, and that is where your feet have become embedded. So you start by being sure. What does that mean again? I have a word. It is my sure word. It is my assured word. This word specifically deals with this situation. So I am sure. To be sure is in the Greek lexicon, to be sure actually means to have foundation. To have foundation. That's number one. Be sure. Number two is T for tenacity. Let me give you the English meaning or meanings for the word tenacity. It means the quality of fact of being able to grip something firmly. So you are now assured. You have your word. That's your assurance. It's your word. You now need tenacity. Tenacity is you grip it. You lay hold of it. There is a book you must read. It's called Grit. You lay, G-R-I-T. You lay hold of it. Tenacity also means the quality of fact of being very determined or having great determination, or the quality of fact of continuing to exist or persist. Tenacity is, it's not looking good, but I have my assurance and I'm sticking with it. See, how do you remain tenacious? How do you remain tenacious even in the midst of opposition? How do you remain tenacious when it looks like it's falling? How do you keep your heels in the sand and keep your place when it looks like it is impossible? Remember, you have your assurance, you have the word, you've determined that you are not going to be moved. Now you're asking the question, how do I ensure I stay firmly rooted? It leads us to the A, number three, affirmation. You need to affirm that assurance that you have. The only way you can be tenacious is through affirmation. What do I mean? You keep saying it. Oh my goodness. Oh, somebody needs to hear the voice of God. You keep saying it. You keep saying it. You are tenacious by affirming, or you remain tenacious by being consistently affirmed, by consistently affirming the truth that you have received. Whatever assurance or surety you have received, because what's our surety? Our surety from God is the word, and that's S. Our surety from God is the word. Because you have that surety, you must be tenacious. To be tenacious, you must practice affirmation. Affirmation is how you lay hold, is how you keep a firm grip. So it says you feel it in your body, you feel it in your emotions, you keep a firm grip. The Bible speaks about holding firm to our profession of faith. Holding is talking about tenacious, being tenacious and affirming. It says hold firm to your profession of faith. You must be tenacious, and to be tenacious, you must consistently affirm the truth. Somebody needs to hear the voice of God this morning. Do not act as if you are without help. Do not act as if as if God has forsaken you. How can he forsake you? He died to prove that you are the most important thing in the heavens, on the earth, and to the devils. The most important. So saints, it means then everything that is required for us to be established has been given to us. You have your surety. You are tenacious through affirmation. The next thing you must pay attention to is deal with the negativity around you. You need to deal with it. If you need to switch up the radio because that news coming in is beginning to struggle with your affirmation, switch it off. If you need to switch off your child, because what they are saying, when I say switch, I don't mean kill them, of course. But you need to tune out what they are saying, because what they are saying is beginning to rob you of your faith. You need to do that. You need to deal with the negative voices and negative impulses that are being thrown at you. Those things have the ability to stifle and to attempt to strangle your ability to remain tenacious. There are some people around us that just being around them, you feel your energy being sapped. You finish with them and you are more depressed. You finish with them and you feel unclean. You need to deal with that. You need to deal with the negativity. Maybe you need to switch off that TV. Maybe you need to stop listening to those breakup love songs, because they are feeding in negativity into your soul. You are saying, you are speaking truth, you are hearing lies. You are speaking truth, you are hearing lies. Saints, listen, what I'm about to say, please don't take it the wrong way. Some lies are couched as facts. Some lies are couched as facts. What is a lie? A lie from God's perspective is this: that which does not line up with the truth of his word. With the truth of his word, from his perspective, everything that is at variance to that is a lie. So on the earth, it might be truth or what they call, or it might be true or what they call fact. But from God's perspective, it might be true, but it's not truth. What is truth? Truth is that which God says it is. That is truth. No matter what the doctors have told you, you can feel it in your body. It is what the doctors have said. Now, it is a fact. It is true on the earth, but it is not the truth. From God's perspective, it is a lie. It is a lie. Some lies are couched as fact. So do not let the fact that somebody calls it a fact to make you feel as though it is your truth. It is not your truth, because your truth and my truth is what the word says it is. So you have your surety. You have a word for that situation. You are tenacious. You are tenacious. And to be, meaning you are determined not to move from this point. If God says it's yours, it is yours. If God says you are healed, you are healed. If God says it has been given, it has been given. The circumstances notwithstanding, this is the outcome. It's going to happen this year, 2020. COVID or no COVID, it's happening for me in the year 2020. I see it. It's mine. I take it. That is tenacity. To be tenacious, you practice affirmation. You practice confession. You hold firm to your confession, profession, affirmation of faith. You build a wall and deal with the negativity that is around you. You deal with negativity. And then the last one, this last one is a mental state. This last one, D is for defiance. You see, when you begin to practice defiance, some people will say that you have lost your mind. Some people will say that you are not being realistic. Some people will say that are you thinking or acting like you are better than them? Saints, if you are going to stand and birth the establishment that is within you, because there's a city within you, and that city is begging to be born. Stop seeing yourself as small. That city is begging to be born. Listen, if you are going to birth the establishment within you, you will have to showcase a strong measure of defiance, where you defy what people are saying. Where people are saying, and you say, not me. Where people are saying, but, it says, without me. Where people are saying, but this is spreading, it will miss me. Where people are saying, nobody will get that, I will get it. Where people are saying, it is impossible, not for me. They will think you have lost your mind. Listen, if you are a believer, and people do not think that you have lost your mind, then it's possible that you are too much in agreement with the tenets of the world. Did you hear me? If people are not thinking you are crazy, then you are probably in agreement with the tenets of the world. It is time to defy everything. Defy everything that is going against what you are standing on. Are you listening to me? I want to close with this. When we speak about stand, we're also saying stand your ground with respect to your integrity. Stand your ground with respect to your integrity. If you have to lose that job to maintain your integrity, get counsel. But if you have to lose that job, not be promoted, because you need to stand your ground for what you believe, stand your ground. Stand your ground. The Lord will come through for you. Stand your ground. If that boyfriend or girlfriend needs to walk away because you are not going to put it out, let them walk away. Stand your ground. We are not of them that put our hands to the plow and we look back. That's not us. We stand our ground. We have chosen a path of divine integrity because in us is the Almighty Himself. We stand sure. Look, we cannot be compromised. We will not give ground. This is who we are. This is what we stand for. And so we stay standing. And I guarantee you, you will birth your establishment. So, in conclusion, hold that word. Hold that word. Can I share with you something I just put on Facebook? It was a scripture that came alive for my kids and I when we did devotion last night. And I put it on Facebook. Hebrews 1, verse 3. Who being the brightness of his glory? Just the first part. Who being the brightness of his glory? Speaking about Jesus. And the express image of his person. And upholding all things by the word of his power. Stop there. Jesus, the pattern son, is the brightness of God's glory. He is the express image of God's person. And he upholds all things by the word of his power. 1 John 4:17 says, as he is, so are we. It then means you are the brightness of his glory. You are the express image of his person. Oh, please give me a bit of time. Let me see if I can open it here for you and show you in other translations. Let me see if I can do that. I want to show you in other translations. Verse 3, Hebrews 1, verse 3. It says, God's Son has all the brightness of God's own glory. I'm reading to you from the Century English Version. God's Son has all the brightness of God's own glory and is like him in every way. By his almighty word, he holds the universe together. Saints, because you are baptized into Christ, 1 John 4:17 says, as he is, so are you. Watch this. It means you are the brightness of God's own glory, and you are like him in every way. I like the Passion. Leave the Passion translation there. It says you, because if it's Jesus, then you are the dazzling radiance of God's splendor. You are the exact expression of God's true nature. What can defeat you? You are the exact expression of God's true nature. God's true nature means integrity and ability. It means character or an ability. And you know my word, character, ability. You are the somebody say it with me. I am the exact expression of God's true nature. You are the exact, like Jesus. Forget what you are going through. Forget how you behave. You are the exact expression of God's true nature. That is why you are undefeatable, more than a conqueror, indefatigable. You cannot be overcome. Rather, you overcome the world. You overcome every opposition. Why? Because in the Century English Version, it says there, let me put it up. In the Century English Version, it says there that you are like him in every way. You are like, say it with me, I am like God in every way. Meaning, when we say that, it means when you show up, God has showed up. Because it doesn't just mean you are like him, like you look alike. No, it's more than that. If it says you are like him in every way, it means when you show up, God has showed up. But don't end it there. The last part says, by his own mighty word, he holds the universe together. By his own mighty word, he holds the universe together. Saints, that's where I want you to see. How does he keep it all together? By his mighty word. God's word in your mouth is mighty. It is mighty. You hold it together because you are the exact expression of God's true nature. You keep everything together by his mighty word. Oh, there is somebody online. Forgive me. I just want to do some personal business. Anita, I want to welcome you formally, even on this platform, to the family of the city of Zion. Welcome back home. It is good to have you as part of the family. It is a joy to have you here. If you are watching and you want to be part of our glorious family, it will be a joy to have you. Click the link, go on our website, fill the membership form. It'll be good to have you. You hold it all together like Jesus does. Why? How? By speaking, by the declaration of your mighty word. Your words are mighty. Today, you have a surety. Your surety is the word. So get that word. Be tenacious by practicing affirmation. Block out the negativity and then stand in defiance. Stand in defiance. I believe and I see glory all over you. You are the exact expression of the true nature of God. Let the world see that they have come up against an establishment. God bless you. Bow your heads as I pray. Whew, we stand. And the only outcome is victory. Victory on all sides, for we stand. Thank you, my Father, for the grace thereof has been given. For we are your exact expression. We are your exact expression. Everyone sick in body, be healed now. Check your body. That depression, I rebuke from your mind. That confusion, how can you be confused? No more, for Christ is your wisdom. That challenge, you rise above it. Your faith cannot fail. Thank you for testimonies have come even now. Receive the praise in Jesus' name. And God's people said, amen. God bless you. If this has blessed you, share it with somebody else. Oh, someone is just asking how they can become a citizen of Zion or a member in Zion. Very easy. Go to our website, click the membership tab there, fill the form. Someone will reach out to you. It will be a joy to welcome you to the family. And you can be part of our family from anywhere in the world. Anywhere in the world, We'll hook you up to a City Life group. That's our cell group. We will plug you into a department. You can be part of this family from anywhere in the world. God bless you. Have a wonderful, wonderful Wednesday. This week is your week. Stand. Bye for now.
We thank you for listening. And now two important questions you must ask yourself. What did the message say to me? And what, if any, is my response? A quick note to join us again for our online Sunday service with Pastor Tim Grage via Facebook next week at 9 a.m. And also, tune in for the live daily devotionals from Monday to Friday at 8 a.m. For your tithes and offerings, here are the banking details. Please note that your heartfelt giving to the kingdom in this season will aid the many struggling financially at this time. And so we thank you for your generosity. We look forward to hosting you at the City of Zion at 93 Grayston Drive in Sandton soon.